Yeah, I make my own bread from scratch. And what's funny is, when I started doing tutorial videos, I asked people, what's the number one tutorial you would like me to do? Whether it's Photoshop, Adobe Animate, and everyone basically said, bread. So, what I'm gonna do is eat my bread. And we're gonna get back to Spider-Man. Hey everyone, welcome back. So a couple weeks ago, I was showing you guys how to animate in Animate by using... I can't wait for them to change the name of that. That's really weird. What else are you gonna do in Animate? A couple weeks ago, we took a look at the first part of animating a Spider-Man type of character in Adobe Animate. Today, we're gonna go ahead and finish that up. Let's go to the computer. As a reminder, let's go ahead and run through this animation. My next steps were to create these two circles because I wanted to get a good feeling for what the body was going to be doing. Again, everything has to do with what it looks like and just make sure that the rhythm is good to go. So if we hit play, we see the shoulders following the shoulders, and then the bottom section is following the groin section. Just to give you a good understanding of what those circles represent or what those circles are doing, let's hide the animated roughs. And here we have a makeshift web and shoulders and the bottom. This gives us a good understanding of what the shoulders are going to be doing compared to the web, compared to the waist. My next step was creating the body outline. So let's hide the circles and see what the body would look like with the test web. And that looks pretty good. I want you guys to notice how I'm not spending a lot of time on details while I'm trying to animate something. It's step by step, and I'm not overdoing a certain step. Once I got the body to act the way I wanted it to, then I colored it up. And that looks like this. And you can slowly see our character coming to life. Now that we have the body animated and colored, let's go ahead and take a look at the head. So we're gonna turn the head layer on, and I'm gonna go ahead and turn on this guide layer too. So you can see, what I ended up doing was creating a line that follows the shoulders because the head is connected to the shoulders and will follow the shoulders. And to animate something on a guide layer in Animate, let's say I have this line here and we can curve it, create a new layer, get the oval tool and make a new shape. I'm gonna turn that into a graphic symbol. And you see this little dot here. If you hit Q, you get all these wonderful handles. And this dot here is kind of like the guide center point. So I'm gonna line that up with that line. I'm gonna right click on the layer with the line and click on guide. Click the layer with the symbol in it, drag it into that guide layer. Come over to however many frames you need, hit F5 just for a frame, no keyframe or anything. However, on layer 2, which is where we have our symbol, hit F6 and that'll create a keyframe. And then what we're gonna do is drag that symbol to the end where we want it, come to this first frame, right click, and drop down to where it says Create Classic Tween. And now when you drag, it's following that path. And that's what I did with the head. And if we take a look, so far so good. Let's go ahead and turn off that guide or hide that guide layer. And now we see that the head and the body are doing what we wanted them to. Let's hit pause, rewind. We might as well go ahead and turn on the web. And if we zoom in, we see that we have the outlines and colored, and it looks a little bit more like a web than just some animated line. So we can hide that now. Okay. Now we have body, head, and web animated. But how is our body connected to the web? Let's take a look. Every time I set up a character and I do right side, left side, left leg, I always take a look at the actual character. Not my left and right, but the character's left and right. That's just for consistency. I'm going to click back over here so we can see the similarities between that ball and the hand that we're about to play with. We have this pivot point here, and like I showed you earlier, it's following that curve. I'm going to click on this arm so you can see there's that pivot point I was telling you about. One thing to remember, if you're animating and you set the path and that little control point, if I were to move this control point, it would kind of ruin the animation. So make sure that you have everything lined up the way you want to before animating. So we see now that this hand is following this curve and it's connecting our body to the web. And there's a little bit extra here that just goes up and then drops back down. And while we're here, we might as well turn on the left arm. And now our guy is really hanging on. You remember that little tail from the web that we talked about before? We might as well turn that on too. If I hit the Alt key and click on the eyeball for that layer, everything else is hidden. So if we flip through this animation, we see that this little bitty tail is following along. And then comes back. And this is that part of the secondary animation that we were talking about. So let's turn on the right arm and the body. And of course the head. What else did we have on? Left arm and the web. Okay, cycle through these animations so we can see that all together, all of this stuff is starting to make sense. Little follow through. A little bit of squash and stretch. Definitely some squash and stretch on that little tail of the web. We have most of the body animated. Let's turn on some legs. So let's take a look at these legs. You see the back is arching. And once you get to the bottom, the legs, the gravity grabs a hold of the legs and starts pulling them down. And then when you get to the top, one thing that adds a little bit more of natural feel to the animations is not letting the appendages do the same exact thing at the same exact time. When we get to the top of the swing, I'm going to bring one leg up first, and then I'm going to have the second one follow. And on the way back down, we can do the same thing. And they stretch, gravity takes hold, and we come to the top and the reverse of what happened over there. And actually here you see, even though the legs are in the same position, they're finishing up the follow-through animation at different times. We have our guy swinging, but we need a really cool background to help sell the fact that he's swinging from something. A white background doesn't really do too much for us. So I added a sky layer. And if you notice, I have three different layers of buildings. The very background building layer, I have just as a simple gray, and I have the opacity of that turned down to about 50%. Because in nature, if we're standing outside, the farther something is, the more it blends into the background, into the sky. This middle layer is not quite as detailed as this front layer. That front layer of buildings is a lot more detailed because the closer something is to us, the more of that thing we can see. The farther, the less we can see. And let's click play to see our spider dude swinging through the city of, I guess Spider-Man's from New York. We'll give New York this one. Well played, New York. Well played. And there you go. We just animated a spider. I wonder if we can say Spider-Man without getting in trouble. Spider Dude. We animated Spider Dude in the streets of New York in Adobe Animate. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. If you know anyone that might learn something from this video, go ahead and share it with them. And of course, subscribe. Thanks again for stopping by the channel. Take care. See you next time.